Well, I'm Ranger Cookie. Now I'm out here in the middle of nowhere, well, close to a road. But everybody just shows us their bug out bag. And a bug out bag is a place, I mean, not a place, but a bag of goods to go out in the middle of the woods to get away from civilization. So, most people have a place to hide, basically that's what it's all about, to get away from other humans in case something happens, something really bad happens. But do you have a bug out house or a bug out place where you can go until you're ready to leave to your real bug out place? Well, I'm gonna show you one of my bug out areas. That's a little pond here, huh? I can get some fresh water, but I'm gonna show you my bug out place. Most people have a bug out bag, but do you have a bug out place too to go with it? Until you're ready to leave to go to your area where you want to be? I'm gonna show you my bug out place real quick. If I can find it. Come on. Ah, there it is. Alright. I'm gonna show you my bug out area. And here it is. Alright, this is my bug out area. If I have to leave and leave my house because something bad is happening and I have to get out of Dodge. So I got this little bug out area. And yes, it needs a little work. But if I have to bug out and get out of Dodge, this is where I go. Yes, it needs repairs. But, like I said, if you need a bug out place, I have one. Where is your bug out house? Alright, this is one of my places that I bug out to if I have to. It's like a safe house. The difference from a safe house and a bug out house is about the same, but a safe house more got lights and electricity. This is a bug out house. There's a couple of little ponds nearby. I can get water from it or items that I need. It's just a temporary fix until I get a better place or move on to the next area. And this is just one of them. Alright, I'm just showing you my bug out house or safe house. Alright, see you next video. You're going to see my other bug house. Abandonment. Makes me wonder why people abandon their stuff. Well, I'm back. This is bug out house number 2. I want you to take a good look at this place. It has a big, nice front porch. I can put all kinds of stuff here. I got a nice iron door. Inside this iron door, I have a nice big open area. You see, I have a tub, a bathroom, fireplace, nice iron door. And it won't take long to rebuild or clean this out to make a living quarters here if I have to. And that's bad. I hate that. I hate when water stays up. If I had a way, I can dump that. This is my other bug out house. This is bug out house number 2. Take a look outside. I got a nice fire chimney. I can cook stuff. And a big open area. See, I can put boards going across here. And put a tarp over it. And protect me from the elements. Well, from the rain. But this is bug out house number 2. I hope you enjoy the series of the bug out houses. This is number 2. Let me know which one y'all like the most, number 1 or number 2. There's more houses, more bug out houses to come. All right, this is number 2 of the bug out house of the Ranger Kooky. I'm back. I'm here to show you number, shit, sometimes you just forget the numbers, number 3 or number 4. I have to slap my face sometimes. Look at this beautiful oak tree here. Alright, I want to show you number 3 or number 4. I get the numbers all confused. Alright, I showed you a trailer, I showed you an old building. What else I showed you? Sometimes you just forget, old age. Alright, but here's number 3 or 4. This is my outer bug out house. This is a 2-story old house in the middle of nowhere. As you can see, it's just sitting here. There you go. Let's take a look inside of this one. Check the bees. Alright, take a look at this one. It's more solid. It does have... Last time I came, that was still there. Over time, it's going to rot. The complete building's going to be completely gone. But still good for right now for surviving. And you can take these styrofoam corks. Styrofoam and make corks out of it. Put some cork line, trout line on it. You can also make it an insulated building. But this is number 3 or 4. I want you to take a look upstairs for me. In case there's a dead body up there. Any dead bodies? Alright. Alright, now I'm going to show you number 5 or 4 bug out house. And a little closet here, a doorway goes into the one little room. A little closet for hot water heater, bathroom, closet, another closet, living room. And upstairs could be bedroom. This place is a little bit more sturdy, but the roof did come on down more than that was all up there, except for the hole. But over time, this building will completely rot and be back to earth. It will come besides the styrofoam plates that's going to be sitting on the bottom of the ground at the end. So we're going to take a look at this if I'm still alone. All right. Look at that. Can you find any houses nearby? Hey, let's go through this window. See any houses nearby? I'm scared to walk over here, but if I walk on the styrofoam, there you go. All right, let's go to the next bug out house. So this is number 3 or 4. I forget the numbers. All right, see you in the next video. Well, I'm back with another bug out house. I just want to show you some of the property. It's nearby, what it's all about. We got an old toy truck. Man, it looks like a lawnmower. That's a baby lawnmower. Look at that, how cute. All right, over here, we got the old boom box septic tap. We got an old TV. That looks cool. PC pipe tent. Let's get that net off the ground. You never know when you're going to need it one day. Catch a bird or something. I just want to show you this area. Nice little fire pit. Come on over here and show you the next bug out house. This is number 4 or 5. And some old cars. Come see this, how old these babies are. See, last time I was here, the trailer wasn't hit by a tree. God, wait. Last time I was here, that wasn't across that at all. That kind of sucks now, but this is the bug out house. Checking for bees. Kind of scared. Yeah, 2 trees fell across this house. It wasn't like that before. Alright, let's take a look. Alright, no bees. Let's take a look inside. This is bug out house number 4 or 5. Alright, let's take a look. We got a ceiling fan and some bees. Not live, of course. Yeah. And the house got hit again. But another tree, because I used to go in that room back there. And just to show you, you know, we still got a nice place to go to if all things fail. And there's the other room that you used to get to. I believe a little cleaning and a little house maintenance will get this place ship shape and ship. I just want to show you my other bug out house. It's a little rotten. A little rotten my ass. But that's number 4 or number 5 bug out house. I think people do believe, I do believe people need a good bug out house. You never know when you need another place in the middle of the woods. If you see, that trailer has been out here for a while. It's made back in the, looks like in the 60s. 60s trailer. If I'm not mistaken, there's some more houses that way. And there's that shed. So we're going to take a little walk real quick. Just do a little adventure in the area because I didn't do a lot here. I don't want to be in certain spots with my car. All these bug out houses are walking distance. Some of them might be about 5 miles, 6 miles, a mile, and a few feet to get to them. I just want to show you. But remember, I had a couple of trees out here. What is that? Mosquito trap, that's what that is. A bird nest. I don't like it. There you go. No skeeters. So if your kids or you need a bug out house, it's a good thing to have to bug out if you have to. I notice over time, leaves and trees will disappear and you can see more into the woods like I'm seeing today. It was like a little trash pile. They threw cans at. Big nice old tree over there. Look at that nice old tree. So we got some good stuff out here. We just have to investigate and see. Because you remember, my motto is trash for survival. Using trash to survive is my motto. So let's take a look at the rest of the trash that we can probably scavenge it up and use to survive. Look at Turlet. Yeah, nice oak tree. Beautiful oak trees out here. It looks like some kid's campground that had old mattress thing here. Yeah. That's a fixer-upper. Looks like a garden area. A lot of people have plots and pets. Ah, see, there was the other house. Or used to be a trailer. What is that? Let's investigate. Oh, okay, so fence. Fence fell. Could be a chicken coop. Yeah, see, there's another fence over there. So they had animals here. Boy, this is a nice place to camp at. There's some type of box frame here. An old house or something. Look at that big old tree. So here's another place I recommend to bug out to if I have to. I can get here within a half a day. Walk with my gear. And that's it. Alright, this is number 4 or 5. I don't know the numbers. It's all scrambled in my brains. I just want you to remember, if you're going to bug out, bug out. Don't stay around. If you need to leave, go. Get scrammed. Don't stay around if you had to bug out. Because staying at your home, people are going to break into it and hurt you or hurt and steal your stuff. But if you bug out and get into your bug out house, you're safe. Alright, I'm Ranger Kooky. I think this is all my bug out houses. If I got another one, I'll add on to it. But I see y'all later. I hope y'all enjoy the bug out house. Look, it's the flying horsey. Well, alright, I'm at, should be my last bug out house. Or safe house, or whatever you want to call it. I did find, I remember another one in my brain. And it's, I notice all these houses always by these big oak trees. Look at that big oak tree back there. We're going to take a look at it after a while. So I'm going to show you my other bug out house. It's a trailer. I've been hit by a tree lately. Most of my places that I know have been hit by a damn tree. Which sucks. Let's take a look. Oh yeah, I got one more. Not recommend to stay here for a long period of time. But it is a place to stay for warmth and comfort. But this place is a little too old to be a bug house anymore. But you can stay here until you get where you need to go. It's probably dark as hell. You can't see a damn thing. But this is a nice little spot to bug out if you have to. Let's go take a look by that oak tree. Damn. We got a tree house in this one. Look at that nice big oak tree here. That's probably the next thing I want to do. See if I can make a clubhouse or a something to live in a tree and get off the ground. Let's see if that works. Or tie a hammock up there, way up there into two high trees. That was a good thought, but I'm not a climber, so I'll probably die for your entertainment. Ranger Cookie dies today of climbing a tree. Trying to put a hammock up and fell to his death. Damn hat. I've been having problems with my hat all day. Wow, that string. Damn you, boy. All right, well, here's another bug out. I'm not even going to give numbers no more because there have been so many. You can count them if you want. This is another little bug out house, but it's too far gone to make it a bug out house, but it used to be a good one. So we're going to count yes, no, it could have been, it was, now it's too far gone to even camp in this one. All right, Ranger Cookie, see you next video. All right, this is another bug out house, and believe it or not, I used to live in this trailer. Let's take a look. It is cool to come out to visit a place that you used to live at and see how well it grew, all grown. Like I said, believe it or not, I used to live in this trailer for about 3 years. And I don't remember these drums out here. Used to be a driveway right here. During Hurricane Katrina, a tree fell on it, destroying the back part of the trailer. I just want to take a look at it, how long it's been since I lived in this place. And somebody was taking the sides off. They took the wires out. Man, this place changed over time. I come here time to time to take a look at it and see how well it changed over time. And boy, did it change a lot. This used to be another trailer over there, but they took that one out because it was worth money. This one's a little older. It's not worth money, worth a damn. But let's take a look at this old trailer that I used to live in. Let's bring back some memories. Oh yeah. Check for bees. All right, give me a second, folks. Gotta put my machete up. All right. Damn, they tore the hell out of this place. Bunch of thieves. This used to be the washer and dryer. A wall here went to the tub, the toilet, the sink. This was my room. Used to be my room. closet was right here. It's gone now. Yeah, it's weird. This used to be my friend Andrew's room right here. He made a little shelf, put a hot water heater, two shelves, and his TV. And he had his little bed here. He lived in a small, small quarters. Then we went into the living room. My TV was right here. Sofa. I had my safe in here. Damn it. I wonder if I got stung by a bee. And here was the ice box, the kitchen sink. That tore the hell out of this place. Boy, this was after the copper and everything in this place. Boy, I remember this place was like yesterday. Alright. Now this place could be used, if you can see me, can be used as a safe house because it's still in good condition. Alright, I think this is my last one of the safe house. This can be used as a safe house because it's in good condition. You got a nice roof in the living room and the front part. So I'm Ranger Cookie and I'll see you next video. I hope you enjoyed the bug out house. It could have been a little dark. I know you couldn't see some of the places. But I just hope you enjoy my safe house versus bug out house, which is the same thing, I believe. And bug outs versus bug out bag and bug out houses. Alright, I'm Ranger Kiki. I'll see you next video. Whoa, 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 whoa.